another news, Pfizer says it's time for COVID booster. However, the FDA and the CDC says not so fast. Thoughts?
Okay, well, the last booster shot I got, I was 4 years old. And they had to give me a shot in a place that I don't believe you're supposed to get a shot. I remember that being four years old. I promise God, never again. So I want to tell you, if we have to get that shot, I can't do it. I've done my part. I've done enough. So that's it. I can't help them. So I just I got to go out there with a mask and take my chances because I had enough. You know what I'm saying?
Man, Pfizer's trying to run up the till, man. You know what I mean? Yeah. They're trying to run out the clock, man. They're like, okay, you know, time for a booster, and you're going to get a booster every year, man. They're just going to have the CDC or whoever just have us over a barrel. So, and people just are going to be over the barrel, and the nation is just supposed to keep paying for it. I don't know how that works. I guess they probably get, I think they probably have a government contract or something like that, and that's how they get paid. But, you know, yeah. So I got CDC and all of them like, listen, man, we can't keep doing this every year. It's costly or whatever. And I don't know what the plan is, man. I really don't know what the plan is.
But the data, the data doesn't show that they need. That's why
it's a we need the booster shot. It's not showing that we need the booster shot.
All right.
Yeah. But I think the bigger problem is having this discussion openly. It gives a lot of people doubt, a lot of people pause. You have people that were not interested in this in the first place. People didn't think it was necessary in the first place. And now they look like they messed up. And so if it looks like those of us who have taken it are guinea pigs, then it justifies a lot of people not taking it. And to me, it looks like poor leadership. It looks like a poor rollout. And it's given a lot of people pause to think about why they should or shouldn't have taken it in the first place. And that's the problem. So this looks really, really bad because that's why people took a wait and see approach. Cause they're like, y'all don't know enough. And if you knew enough, then you projected this from the beginning. And since you didn't, you can't just experiment on me. Yeah. And that's why a lot of people, it looks bad. It really looks bad. And I'm a person that has taken it and I know it looks bad. So right. What I do, and I said this from the beginning, people that didn't take it, I didn't condemn them or knock them because I totally understand. And people like me that did take it, I took it because I knew, you know, the people, the places I work, it was going to be required and the things that I have to do. So I knew what it was. And it looks bad because people feel like it was forced and rushed. And so I understand it. So if I'm not here for the next birthday, then y'all go and represent and let them know I wasn't no punk, though.
Went out with your boots on. That's right, man. I hear you.
Nah, I respect what you just now said, Calvin. Yeah. The thing is, like, this, I mean, let's be open, like you just said. Like, how can you not look at this and say, I have major concerns?
Right.
I have major concerns.
Right.
So now the thing is, you got to look at, like, they put the fear of God in everybody. They made everybody believe if you caught COVID, you were going to die. You know what I'm saying? And that made everybody go out and get vaccinated. You know what I mean? And, you know, when you really look at the numbers, the numbers don't add up to where that everybody that got it was going to die.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You had, I think the last time I looked, you had 500,000 people that died from it. And I'm not downplaying 500,000 people dying because that's a lot. But when you look at how many people had it, which I think at the last time I looked, it was over 38 million. That's less than 1%.
Right.
So it wasn't as deadly as everybody tried, as the media tried to push on everybody to run out and get vaccine.
Right.
Now, the thing is, we are talking about four publicly traded companies, Pfizer, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson, and AstraZeneca, right? So here's the thing, right?
He's in those 600K. Okay,
600K is okay, it's still less than 1%. So less than 1%. So the bottom line is this, they kept telling everybody how many people died, but they're not emphasizing how many people survived or basically got it and didn't even feel that they had it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So that's my issue with it. Like they put fear into public and people ran out there because they were afraid and they took the vaccine. You know what I'm saying? Now back to the three publicly traded companies, right? Now, Johnson & Johnson, they fucked up baby powder, right? They fucked up baby powder
They gave me a rash. They gave me a rash.
Well, it gave some people more than that. It gave them cancer.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So the thing is, they lied that it wasn't baby powder for years before they got to the point where they had to admit that it was the baby powder. You gotta look, if you remember back in the days, tobacco did the same thing. They lied to you, said, oh, you can't get sick from it, cancer. They hid that for 11 years. You know what I'm saying? The thing is, this thing is about money now. It's not about freaking saving people. It's about making money. You know, and like I said, I'm not trying to play a doctor, and I'm not even trying to play a doctor on TV. But the bottom line, your body fights off certain viruses and flus if you are healthy. People that got really sick from COVID is because they had a vitamin D deficiency, which means their immune system wasn't big. You know, right. What I mean, wasn't
general, but you know same observations. You know what? You know what, Brad? I'm gonna tell you the thing about what frightened me the most about COVID, because the numbers for survivability didn't frighten me. It's just the contagiousness of it. You know what I mean? They just pushed it like the minute you're going to walk outside, you're going to catch COVID.
Correct,
like that.
Correct.
You know
what I mean? Correct.
And just the sheer numbers of that, when you just crunch the numbers of how contagious it was, you know, there's going to be deaths. You know what I mean? That's going to come from that. It's you know, severe sickness. And I get that they wanted to put the stuff out, that they wanted to put it out ASAP. But anything that's that rushed, assuming of course that they didn't have any prior knowledge and didn't do any previous research on it, anything that's rushed is not going to come out. The minute you take that, you're automatically a guinea pig. And the fact, and it kind of gave it up early when they said, when they started giving it out for free, and then they wanted to do all sorts of follow up. They told you in the beginning because they wanted to follow up and see how it reacted. So that just let you know off the top you were going to be a guinea pig. And matter of fact, Johnson & Johnson just kind of came out of nowhere with their vaccine. I've never tried, and like Rodney, I've never trusted them. I think right now they got a recall going on for shampoo right now. You know, yeah. So I mean, I don't know where they were coming from with their research. You know, Pfizer I could kind of understand. I never heard of Moderna until now.
Until the vaccine.
Derek,
this is my position on, and this is the last I'll say on this. This is what it is to me. When you want to add a booster shot, what I'm saying is, if you got the CDC going against what they're recommending, if you got a conflict there, if this is hashed out in the public, it's just going to breed more doubt. So whatever it is, you've got to have a clear, concise path with it in that, and leave it at that. But once you start adding different things or something on something they're already having a problem with our community taking, now it's just adding to people's uncertainty and apprehension. And mm-hmm. So when you want to start rolling this stuff out, music videos are not going to help it. Clever cartoons are not going to help it. Getting celebrity endorsements are not going to help it. People basically are afraid, and I think people are concerned what they put in their body. And so therefore, you've got to actually have one position. And if you don't have it, then people are going to say, I'm apprehensive and I'm sitting out. And that's reality. And plus, as for most people in our community, don't always jump for something when it's free. They jump for it when it's exclusive. It's like Jordan's coming out at midnight. Then if you say, well, we're going to make sure y'all get the best.
Here go my take on it. I agree with you, Kelvin, wholeheartedly on certain things. Like, a person that had it so bad and still, now today, I just came from a pulmonologist today. So I have a different take on it. Like, when people, like, you could say people, 600,000 died, that's 600,000 funerals. Some people have funerals. Okay. Like Brad said, until you go to a funeral, to your experience. I think people that have experience have a different take. I understand the money grab. I said it from the jump, even in our group text. It's a money grab for me for Pfizer. However, I had to think about other family members. My mother had breast cancer. Her immune system done. I had to take it for that to make sure if I want to bring that to her. Like, now we got this Delta variant that's going around, like sticking out. Chicken Wing just lost his partner yesterday. His homeboy died yesterday from the Delta variant of COVID.
Wow.
In Maryland. So like, we just was going through this. So it just, to me, when people say certain things, they didn't experience what I experienced. So I said, I don't even argue with you no more. I just don't do it no more because it don't make sense.
No, see, D, totally understand that. But like I said before, it was also about a health issue. The people that didn't do well with it is because they didn't have a high immune system. They had vitamin D deficiencies. So I'm not downplaying people dying. I didn't downplay 500.
But you can't say only people with vitamin D deficiencies die.
They mostly people that died from it had vitamin D deficiencies, or they had some other ailments. And the other thing, those numbers are not going to be completely accurate, because in the last 2 years, everybody died from COVID. If you was in a car accident, you died from COVID. Those numbers are not accurate.
Okay. No, I get it. And I think what you guys are talking about is a little different than adding this last piece to it. That's all I'm saying. Because again, and for everybody at home, we're not offering medical advice.
We're not doctors, we're not telling people what to do. But the bottom line is, if you at this stage already, you either took the vaccine or you didn't.
But here comes my argument with that, when you say that all the numbers are juke. Now I have a friend that owns a funeral home, and Bradley knows the friend that we learned how to swim, her father taught us how to swim. The thing with also you saying that it was changed. Now she's saying with people that she known that had COVID, the body when they was in the hospital, family told them when she gets the death certificates, it doesn't say COVID deaths on it. They're not paying money for the COVID funerals anymore. So now they're just writing off for something else because the government don't want to pay for them. So you can say one hand on one thing. This is why all the numbers are high. Then I could go with somebody that's sitting right there that does death every day of her life.
Yeah, bro. I know some people that died as well. I have family members who had COVID, you know what I mean? And I definitely understand everything that's going on with that. I just noticed that, you know, and one of the things that I look at is I know that we have a government or a system here that never seems to waste a catastrophe, you know what I mean? So, you know, you have this situation that's happening. It's obviously a health issue. And then people can just kind of, and then what happens, I've seen cottage industries almost just pop up around this thing. And I'm just wondering how much of it, you know, obviously it's a potentially life-threatening situation, but then I just also understand how much of that is just magnified, you know, how much of the situation or the concern is just magnified profit, you know? So, yeah. You know, that's my largest concern. And, you know, you never really understand, and which when that happens, and when you acknowledge and understand or believe that that's happening, it's kind of natural to wonder, you know, about the seriousness of the situation to begin with, because you don't really know where the whole thing is going, you know. So
I wish I could show you how serious my lungs are. No. When you say the serious, because everything is not money. Sometimes the shit is real.
No.
We're not questioning whether it's real. We're not questioning whether it's real. We know that COVID is real. The issue here is, I was saying that it's not as deadly as they claim it was.
But yeah,
the fear in everybody to run out and get a vaccine.
Even if you live, I'm just trying to tell you how my lungs feel. So if you want to be a long hauler, you can't go up a flight of steps.
And we're not in denial that you had COVID.
No, I'm not saying that. But I'm saying when people saying like, people say, oh, people live, but how will you live later on?
Well, how will you live later on after taking that vaccine? You don't know that.
No. But how you live without it? So you don't know that either.
I'm living without it.
No, I'm saying, but you don't know what tomorrow could bring. That's the thing. So when people argue, listen, I'm not arguing about you not taking it or taking it. I'm just saying when people say, people that have long hauler issues, you're not taking account of, when you say people say people live without, live on, but how your lifestyle is going to change?
That's what you're not factoring in.
Yeah, I'm living, but I'm not living how I was living in 2019.
We're not talking about that.
You just said people live.
More people lived than got COVID.
I understand that, but how are people living that did live that had the virus?
Okay, that's now, what you're factoring in, right? Here's the thing. What's in the vaccine? What's in it?
What's in Doritos?
No, what's in the, I want to listen.
I don't know what's in it.
You don't. That's the problem. You don't know what's in it.
May I ask you a question? How many of y'all know what's in the back of every box of stuff y'all eat?
No, you don't. No, you have an idea. You don't.
You don't know some of the words. People take shit every day that they don't know what's in it. When you go to the hospital, you get an IV, you don't know what's in it. You don't.
Right. You know what this is? This is the thing, right? You take something that's not FDA approved, right? You don't know what's in it, right? And when was the last time that this government or this country did something that was in the benefit of Black community? Now, I listen to the radio, certain radio station, I'm not gonna say who, you play a song, vaccine commercial. You play two songs, vaccine commercial. I have never seen anything in my lifetime where this country is jamming something up black people's ass. I've never seen them looking for our best interests.
But I'll say this, this is the one thing I will say, and I was telling the dude this, that what I will say is, to me, if someone wants to poison us or whatever, it's very easy to do it. They don't.
Yeah,
they don't
it is very easy to do it.
Right. They don't have to go
make it easier for them to do it.
Right. I mean, you can put it, like I said, you can put it in Hennessy, and everybody had been dead last weekend.
But my concern is this, DeMar, to speak to your point. When you go to the hospital or you go to a doctor, you get a prescription from the doctor to give you a medicine or something that is meant to, you know, improve your situation. But let's say the medicine has a side effect, right, that you didn't know about, all right, and it causes some harm. You have a system in place where you can sue, right, and you can get at least financial remedy. What is that thing right now? Right now, you're literally putting something into you, right, that's being given out for free. Mm-hmm. You don't know what it is, and you are right now, they're working it out as they go along. If the vaccine that you're given causes you problems later on, all right, what is your remedy? How will you be made whole? You know what I mean? Now, remember, you got the vaccine proactively because you did not want to catch it. You were perfectly healthy up to that point. But now something happens because you took the vaccine. How do you become made whole? How are you made whole after the fact? So that's my major concern. I need to sit back and watch.
Okay, right. let me ask you a question. Yeah. Y'all guys, some of y'all smoke cigars. Y'all eat all kind of shit. Y'all could get fucked up from it. You know that. Who are y'all suing from that?
No, if I smoke a cigar, we have plenty of information. We says that nicotine, that the cigar, the tar, will cause lung cancer.
Mm-hmm.
That is clearly put out on the label. You are taking a risk. All right. So if you go and you get lung cancer behind that, sorry, you're bad. You don't get to sue anybody. You should have known that. It's not the same thing.
It's the same thing. You just say the risk.
So here's the thing. If you take something, knowing that there's a risk that something can happen to you, all right, and it happens, then yeah, that's on you. You took a shot, you rolled the dice, you didn't do so well, all right? If you go in and you do something and you don't know that something's bad is going to happen to you, and they tell you that there's going to be a benefit, and you find out that not only can they not protect you, or not only there's a thing that they're saying that it's going to help you with, it doesn't help you with, but it also causes a harm to you, then that's their bad. You didn't know. All right. But now I understand in the situation that we're in, sometimes, listen, this was a health thing and we needed to get things back to normal. People were afraid because I always said the real virus was fear. Right. So we had to kind of get that under control. We needed to give people hope and we put the virus out. And in that regard, it did help. All right. It helped us as a people. It helped us as a country. You know what I mean? Just to kind of calm things down. We gave us hope. Sometimes that's what you need. But in the meantime, you still have to collect this information. We're still collecting information on this.
I just think the reality of it is this. Like I said, and I've been like this from the beginning. People that didn't take it, I didn't knock them. I understand.
I don't care.
I think D looks at it like people dismissive over, you know. I'm not saying you. I'm just saying in general, that's what it has been. It has been one side. Yeah. Has been like if you took it, you know, you're being duped. And the other side is like if you didn't take it, you're letting everybody down. I just said everybody has to come to that realization themselves.
Kevin. It was also designed to divide us because people were doing that. People were saying, if you didn't take it, it was designed to divide us, just like it was designed to put fear into people for them to run out and get it. I've never seen anything in this country that basically forced something on us. When did they ever care about our well-being? When?
I'm not a meat eater anymore, right? But yeah. I'm never the person that goes to an event like, you know, you shouldn't be having that because that stuff, it would irritate me, you know what I'm saying? And so that's what it is. But I understand exactly what you all are saying, and I think you made some.
And
very
the thing is,
points.
Too, the vaccine doesn't stop people from getting it. It doesn't stop people even from transmitting it either.
Right.
It doesn't. Right. It just stops you from having symptoms from it. That's what right. it does.
Well, on a lighter note, the boys from New Orleans, Vax That Ass Up song.
Back that thing up.
Yeah. Yeah, Manny Fresh still looks like a AG. Aggressive.
Did they announce if they took the vaccine?
I have no idea.
They should announce the check that they got for it, though.
Right, they took that check.
Yeah, they took that check, though.
You know what? Let me tell you something. When I was at St. John's University, I brought this up in a marketing class. I'm sick of every time they want to present something to Black people, it got to be a beat behind it. I'm just tired of every time somebody got to speak to us. I'm talking about a Burger King commercial. You got to have somebody breakdancing. Like, I'm just always tired of that. And that, you know, that is aggravating. You know,
video. They put that out strictly for what? For who? The Black community, right? Feel we don't understand anything that has to do, unless it has to do with hip hop or diamonds or bling. Right. Look at that logo. Look at that logo. Put it back up there, Jamie. Look at that. It's got bling all over it. It's got speakers. It's got a fancy car with rims. All this stuff, dude, with chains on it. It's insulting. It's insulting.
Hey, man, it's promotion. Somebody out there might get vaccinated just because. Well, if you can look at that and see it, that it's insulting, then it's not for you. It's for people who don't see it, and it might help them. You know what I mean?
I have to admit, if you get a vaccination because you heard this song, they should take that microphone and beat you with it.
Oh, hilarious. Hilarious, man.
Oh, man.